You're looking at a winner right here. That's right, our next guest entered and won the Dean Supply Contest on Fox8.com. Her prize, a cooking segment on New Day Cleveland. So we welcome Stephanie Rowe. And how is this cooking on TV? A little different than at home,
It's a little different. You have to prioritize a little bit better.
You have to do that. So you got some pork steaks here, huh?
I have some pork steaks here. We're going to go ahead and get those browned up. I also have some Brussels sprouts going, and I also roasted the butternut squash ahead of time. It's something that you can do before you go to work. You can get that roasted.
You cook at home all the time?
All the time.
So why in the world do you want to cook on TV? It makes you nervous. You got to figure it out. It's all kind of crazy stuff.
If I didn't cook, I don't know what I would be doing.
So there you go. That's excellent. That's excellent. So you just season those with salt and pepper then,
Salt and pepper. A little bit of olive oil in the pan. After these get browned up, we are going to go ahead and add our onions.
Oh, so this is the thing where you brown it, and then we sort of make it like casserole-ish.
Yeah, you're going to brown them, you're going to set them aside, and then you're going to kind of do your sauce off to the side of the pan, and then you add them back and simmer them.
Okay, let's rock it.
So
while that's cooking right there, what did you have to do to win the contest?
I just signed up on Fox 8, I think on Facebook.
That was it, huh?
Mm-hmm.
And here you are. That's excellent. Would you recommend it to anyone?
Absolutely.
Okay, so you're still having fun.
I'm having fun.
That's good.
I forgot the meat this morning, but...
That was really fun. I didn't know we would reveal that. You put a little olive oil in there with your onions now.
And yes.
Is this
chicken broth.
Oh, chicken broth. Okay, so chicken that's going to break down in its own juices.
Yes.
It was so much fun when Stephanie got here this morning. She's got this all beautifully laid out. And she goes, uh-oh, I forgot the pork steaks. You just can't find those anywhere.
No.
So we ran out real quick and got them, and no problem. And you're cool as a cucumber.
Kind of. We're going to add a little bit of garlic.
Okay.
You want to make sure the temperature is not too hot or it'll burn your garlic.
And burnt garlic is sort of bitter, right?
It's horrible.
So that's cooking now. I wanted to ask you about these beautiful trays over here. You got a beautiful deli tray,
yes.
Candy, pumpkin pie.
Yes, you can get this all at the Food Peddler. They donated this morning for your staff.
Oh, that's great.
They're a new farm market and located on Fulton Road. They have all fresh produce, family owned.
So Fulton Road, is that in Cleveland?
Yes.
It's called the Peddler's Market?
Food Peddler, yes.
Food Peddler, okay, so check that out. It looks pretty, too.
Okay, we're going to add a little bit of brown sugar, probably about a third of a cup.
Mm-hmm. I see a lot of pretty cool stuff here. I see flour is going to come into play, too, huh?
It's going to thicken up the sauce a little bit.
Uh-huh.
We're going to add about a third of a cup of ketchup.
So this is great. So you make the sauce right in the pan.
It's
almost like a one-pan dish.
Mm-hmm. And you can easily throw mashed potatoes together. Mm-hmm. While that's going, I'm going to mix in the Brussels sprouts.
Okay. So do you have kids at home?
I have a 3-year-old daughter who loves to help, especially when I'm rolling dough. She thinks it's Play-Doh.
So you bake also?
Yes, I bake from home. I bake for the Food Peddler.
Oh,
I
you do
pies, fry pies, and mini breads.
So this is your pumpkin pie
yes.
over here? How about that? I'm gonna bring that. Oh, there we go. I'm not gonna move it. I move it, the director comes in here and gives me a punch in the nose. Don't want that.
And this is a great fall. Everything here is in season right now.
How pretty is that?
Way to use your fresh vegetables.
Let's set that right out over there if you can without blowing up your arms. There you go.
And then the best way to do it is top it all with bacon.
What's wrong with bacon on top?
Oh, nothing.
Nothing. I like the way you say that with a gasp in your of breath too. True love.
Now we're going to add a little bit of water.
So you must have a lot of fans for your cooking then, huh?
Yes, I have lots of guinea pigs.
Really? Name a few.
My mother-in-law, Sherry, who's at home babysitting my daughter, this is her recipe.
There's your shout out. There's one. Got time for more even. Oh, so this is nice. See how she works the flour in? So you don't want it to get lumpy, right?
You don't want it to get lumpy, but you need it to thicken it up.
Right.
And if it gets too thick, you can always add water. That's why I added a little bit extra water today.
Right.
And then you put the lid on and you let it simmer for about 25 minutes.
Uh-huh.
And you're going to wait to add the sour cream till the end.
Okay, I was going to ask you about that. Because the sour cream, if you put it in too soon, it breaks up.
It breaks up and then it might curl. So I wait till the end.
Hey, so a little tip with the sour cream. When you put the sour cream in, do you let it stop bubbling when you put it in? And then you never warm it back up again.
Don't warm it back up because it won't be very pretty when you do.
Yeah, because it gets a little bumpy in it.
Mm-hmm.
And so did you write down the recipe so people could have this on our website?
I did.
That's the most fun part of doing this, isn't it?
Hopefully they can follow my directions.
Hey, so if we go over to the food peddler, right, mm-hmm. on Fulton, you make your pumpkin pies, and what other stuff you make for them?
I make fry pies, small quick breads.
Fry pie, that's like a turnover?
Yes. There's apple, cherry, peach, and blueberry.
Uh-huh.
And I also do little quick breads, banana, blueberry, banana chocolate, peach buttermilk.
Great. And you have some good cooking tips, too.
And I have good cooking tips.
Stephanie Rowe, how about a round of applause, audience here, huh? It's pretty good. It's hard to do, and it's fun to do, too. Okay, grab your phone, folks. Now it's time to start dialing. You ready? Thanks to Fox Home Entertainment, one of you is about to win a copy of Modern Family Season 4. It's now on Blu-ray and DVD. So be caller number 8, and it's yours, 216-578-0888. Good luck. And, of course, still to come, we promised you Costco steals and deals. 8 items you wouldn't expect to find at Costco. That's coming up. And once again, thank you, Stephanie.